kitchen at its horrible best. Monstrous man killing plants stalk the earth. Beware, the day of the Triffids has come. An allied artist release with Harold Kill, Nicola Murray, Jeanette Scott, Mervyn Jones, Alison Leggett, Karen Moore, Janine Fay, and Ewan Roberts. Based from the novel The Day of Triffids by John Wyman. Meteorites strike most of the world blind. An exception is Bill Marson, an American seaman recovering from an eye operation in London. He rips off his bandages and leaves the deserted hospital to find a city of gropers. In a Cornish lighthouse are two other exceptions. Tom Godwin, marine biologist, and his young wife, Karen. They hear of disaster by radio. I also learn that outer space has showed Earth as a seed of Triffids, fast-growing giant men killing plants that walk. Mason rescues a fourth exception, Susan, a schoolgirl. Triffid with a harpoon and apparently kills it. He performs an autopsy to learn its nature, begins an experiment for Triffid poison. Each test proves negative. Manson in his charge is stopped at a Spanish farmhouse, blinded, Luis de Vigres, and his lovely wife, Teresa. Christine delivers a woman's baby as Mason, using a gasoline truck, hose as a flamethrower, fights off another Triffid host. Discovering it is a sound that attracts the monsters, he drives off a circus van, with the music playing, leading a grisly parade of killers, bidding Christine, Susan, and the Spaniards to escape another car. In a lighthouse, the Godwin hears a disaster by radio. He also learns the outer space has showered Earth with the seas of Triffids, fast-growing monstrous men killing plants that walk. Another exception of the plague of blindness, Susan Jenny Fay, is enslaved by a sightless bully at a train wreck to act as his guide. The child is rescued by Bill as panic and blackness swirl through a blind world. The monstrous Triffids take the ghastly toil of a blind police as the American seaman adopts the child he rescued. When he learns her parents have been killed, Bill commands a launch to cross the channel. Above, heroic havoc reigns with a crew and passengers of a transport plane, blinded by the deadly meteorite shower, go berserk with fear. The airline crashes, adding its total to the mounting toil, dead and dying on the day of the Triffids. The deadly Triffids, armed with lethal stings, invade the ship. Bill finds the victim of the horror plants. Triffids are swarming all over the world, killing even in the air as his airliner radio operator knew a moment before, being fatally attacked by the monstrous plants. An alien thing enters the homes in search of the prey. Beyond the professor find the body of a pilot whose plane crashes when he was blinded by the meteorite shower. Across the channel, Bill and Susan join Chris Durrant, Nicole Murray, and Professor Croker, Mervyn Jones. His sister, who has also escaped blindness, Christine, has turned the chateau into a hospital for victims. Triffid kills the professor, and Bill carries him away from the invading horrors. The chateau is invaded and taken over by escaped convicts. who see their false, helpless blind woman to join them in a wild orgy. An army of triffids breaks into slaughtering. But Bill rescues Christine and Susan. They begin a long and dangerous journey through a nightmare world, attempting to flee from the dreaded man-killing plants. They head for the Spanish naval base at Amarante, a journey fraught with peril and as they fight off the monstrous triffids. They stop at the house of a blinded Spaniard, his pregnant wife, where Christine delivers the woman's baby. The triffids come seeking new victims. Bill tends to an electric fence, calculated to keep the triffids out, but sees that it will not stop them. In a shed garage, Bill attempts to fashion a flamethrower. Beatra, a blinded peasant girl, is attacked by the triffids and becoming more and more numerous. Bill, using his makeshift flamethrower, finds that the fire is one of the few effective weapons against the man-killing plants. Meanwhile, in the lighthouse, a triffid, which Tom Goodwin thought he killed, revives and attacks his wife, Karen. Karen's scream prompts Tom to turn the hose on the triffid. It dissolves before his eyes. He's found the answer that will save what is left of civilization, common seawater. Alente, Christine and Susan board a submarine, wait for Bill to join them. The end.